Whoa! Help me! I'm being mugged! Travel mugged, that is. This is the Twiz mug by Neolid. This video is not sponsored, by the way. I bought this mug myself after seeing someone talk about it on Twitter because I was intrigued by the way it closes. We're going to talk about the math behind the way it seals today on Michael's Toys. As you can see, when it's closed, it looks a little bit like Uranus has a diameter of more than 50,000 kilometers. That's more than a mile. That's a pretty out of this world fact. But the way the Twiz mug closes is very much of this world. It may look strange, but we use this kind of seal quite often. We do it every time we close up a bag of bread. When we do that, we are taking a sleeve of material and we're giving it a twist. This seal is pretty nice. But from above, it can look a bit like a chocolate starfish. And the Hot Dog Flavored Water was the title of Limp Bizkit's third studio album. It came out in the year 2000, and it was extremely popular with middle schoolers named Michael Stevens who lived in Stillwell, Kansas. But we are here today to talk about this mug. Let's go back to the bread bag first, though. When I close up a bread bag, I am taking, essentially, as I said, a cylinder of flexible material, and I'm rotating the top such that I get a nice tight seal down here. But notice that when I do that rotation, the height of the bag's material shrinks. It begins this tall and it ends up shorter. Lengths of material that originally spent all that length going up, when twisted, have to spend some of that length going forward and right and backwards and left, and they have less of their length to go straight up, so the bag becomes shorter. If I need extra material to keep the height where I want it, why don't I just cuff the material? If I form a little cuff like that, then as I close the bag and it gets shorter, I can surrender some of the material from the cuff and make the cuff shorter and raise it back up to the height that I want. That's exactly what happens in this mug. We have a cylinder of rubbery material, the bottom of which, like the bottom of this bag analogously, is connected inside the mug. The top folds over the lip of the mug and forms a cuff where it then attaches to this external ring. So when I twist the material, the cylinder of material, the external ring goes up, surrendering material to the inside, and we get ourselves a nice seal. The mathematical name for the surface created when you rotate one end of a cylinder is a hyperboloid. Wow, that really does look like a leather Cheerio. Now I've seen everything. There are a lot of different ways to generate a hyperboloid. You can take a cylinder and rotate one of the bases. If you rotate a base of a cylinder pi radians, every line will intersect at a single point. That's a nice seal. On the Twiz mug, if you rotate pi radians, which is 180 degrees, half of a full rotation, it closes up. But the mug itself is actually designed to rotate a bit more than that, so you get a really nice seal that is incredibly watertight. It's quite impressive. But that's not the way of generating a hyperboloid that gives the hyperboloid its name. To figure out where its name comes from, we should look at conic sections. Imagine a double cone, two cones joined tip to tip with parallel bases. Let us now intersect this double cone with a plane. If the plane is parallel to the bases, the intersection will be a circle, or in one case, a point. If the plane, however, is not parallel to the bases, but its slope is less than the slope of the cones, the intersection will be an ellipse. If the slope of the plane is equal to the slope of the cones, the intersection will either be a line, or in every other case, a parabola. Parabola means to throw next to throw near. It's the shape of the trajectory of an object thrown here on Earth's surface. If, however, the plane has a slope that is greater than the slope of the cones, it will intersect both cones, and the intersection is called a hyperbola, where hyperbola means to throw beyond. We get the word hyperbole from the same roots. It means to have kind of gone too far, to have exaggerated, to have been hyperbolic. And watch this, if we take a hyperbola and rotate it around this axis, we get a hyperboloid of two sheets. But if we rotate the hyperbola around this axis, we get a hyperboloid of just one sheet. And this is what our mug is making. The oid ending that we've added to hyperbola simply means akin to, kind of looks like. So a hyperboloid kind of looks like a hyperbola, but like it's not, because it's a surface, not a one-dimensional thing. Anywho, a hyperboloid of one sheet is a ruled surface, which means that it can be constructed by taking a straight line and moving that straight line through space. This is very important, because if you need to build a structure that curves, it's pretty economical to use the hyperboloid, because you can just make it out of straight materials. You don't have to build special curved materials. Cooling towers want big, wide bases so that there's a lot of surface area for evaporation. But it's awesome if they can be a little bit cinched in the middle, because as all the stuff evaporates, it'll rise up and speed up as it reaches this narrower region due to the Venturi effect. Then, the cooling tower expands, which increases surface area again, allowing for more cooling, giving us condensation and evaporation, all the things that we want the cooling tower to do. And all of it can be made with straight beams. One of my favorite ways to exploit the construction of a hyperboloid is the hyperbolic slot. A straight line seems to magically fit through a curved slot. This, of course, is merely a demonstration of the fact that a hyperboloid of one sheet is a ruled surface. One of my favorite applications of a hyperbolic slot was used in a display by Hermes, where an umbrella passes through a slot shaped like a hyperbola. Instructables has instructions on how to make your own out of Lego. Oh, and by the way, two axles that are skewed to one another can still contact each other if their gears are hyperbolic. So hyperboloids are all around us. They're beautiful and they're useful for when you want a container that can hold a liquid, allow you to pour the liquid, and when you don't want the liquid to spill out, seal up. So thank you, hyperboloid. I think you're beautiful, even if when one of your bases is rotated pi radians or more from above, you look a little bit like a b-hole. Be complete. Be 100%. And as always, thanks for watching.